Hello, my Soccer Universe, and now this is the first week since the COVID break that I'm doing separate videos, and we'll start out with the shortest one, which is the Coppa Italia semifinals. Not really having a preview for the final, except that if you look on the screen, I have now the time right. Previously, I didn't have the right time on there. What can I say? Juve stumbles and Napoli is really storming kind of into the storming is the wrong way, but it was a clear performance. It was two totally different games. I decided, since I wore in the what to watch the Juve, now I'm wearing the Napoli jersey, and let's see which jersey I'll be wearing when I talk about the Coppa Italia final. Where to start? Juve Milan. I did not expect much from that game. I'm a Milan fan. I know that Milan was unlucky to not win the game, the first leg. I knew playing at Juventus and away from home, Milan has never done something there, never won there, never, always, in the last few years, always performed well. And there was always this little turn of bad luck that meant that Milan is not winning there, or most of the time losing there. I remember especially the first game at Turin in the season. They played really well, and then Dybala comes in. And, you know, knowing no Ibrahimovic, no Hernandez, not gonna work. I went in with little expectations, but of course I'm gonna watch my Milan play. Same thing, I'm gonna watch my last game if it's not that great at the moment. But for once, I even promised myself I'm not gonna get too depressed about this one, because I'm not expecting much. And the first 50 minutes, Juve played really well, and Milan had no chance whatsoever. Then another contentious penalty given, although I have to say this one I understand more than the one that was given at the first leg in Milan, because there was a clear movement towards the ball. It's stupid, but yeah, Conte, Ronaldo steps up, and I'm saying, okay, that's that. Goodbye, Milan. Juventus, congratulations. Ronaldo steps up, and Donnarumma gets his fingers on it, goes to the post and out. And I'm celebrating. Yeah, a let off. And then immediate action after, Rebic does the most stupid thing ever. I mean, he goes with a high kick onto a ball. Was it Douglas Costa? Whoever it was, he just slams him with his foot into the shoulder. Clear red card. I mean, the moment I saw it, I knew this. There's nothing else but a red card possible there. As devastating as it is. And I said, okay, this is going to be 3-4 goals. And I was even joking about, you know, this might be one of those times where they then really rally together and get a result out of there. And that moment actually broke the game. From that moment on, Milan was sitting tightly. And yes, I question, why not bring on another striker? But on the other side, it was good that the striker was sent off, because you could keep your shape, and Milan was sitting deeper and deeper. But the only thing is, I was always wondering where the goals come coming from, because all three, I mean, Captain Jack maybe the one, but Calhanoglu is not known for his sprinting abilities. So I wasn't, and you know, similar with the others. So I was a little bit wondering there, but you know, at first, let's keep Juve at bay, and they did it fairly well. I have to say, except for a short period in the second half, I never feared that they will concede, and I was actually hoping, maybe there is a lucky punch possible. And it was there. I think Calhanoglu had a nice header that could have been Jar, Kjær had a header. They just couldn't get it on target. If they put it on target, Milan might actually steal a win from there. And so it is, like always, a noble effort going for nothing. They even didn't lose at Juventus, and they still managed to. This is the most Milan thing ever. Juve stumbles into the final. Yeah, they were the better team and so on, but I honestly have to say, this was this season's Milan in perfection. The second game was a much, much better game. Totally enjoyable between Napoli and Inter. The Juve-Milan game was awful. Really awful to watch. Unless you invested interest in either one of those two teams. But honestly, except for the first 15 minutes, where Juve was brilliant. absolutely brilliant. But then with that red card and the penalty miss, gone. Napoli Inter, right from the get-go. Second minute corner, Eriksen directly in. You have to question the goalkeeping for Ospina. Ospina playing a major role in this game. And Inter was, I have to say, for the first 20 minutes, for sure the better team. And they had opportunities to get a goal. But I had the feeling, and the commentator was still saying, yeah, where is Napoli? They are just, they are not really in the game. It's all Inter. But I already had the feeling that Napoli, they were clearly following a counter-attacking strategy. And you could clearly tell that Napoli is trying to hit them on the counter. There were a few semi-dangerous positions. Not really shots on goal, but Napoli got a little bit more dangerous. And then just before the halftime, Ospina gets the ball, kicks it out into the path of Insigne, who runs past Eriksen, who I know is not a sprinter, but that didn't look good. Gets into the box, serves it really sweetly to Mertens, who just has to put it into net. 1-1. Wonderful counter-attacking move. Mertens now the record goal scorer for Napoli, ahead of Hamsik and, of course, Diego Maradona, who I made a video not too long ago. So 1-1, and that meant we will have no penalties. Overtime was already scrapped, which I thought was a smart move from the Italian FA. And now a goal for Inter would put Inter through, a goal for Napoli would secure them. So it was really this nice sweet spot. And I have to say, Inter tried, but Ospina had a great save again on Eriksen and had a few other good moments. But also Napoli, I think especially in the second half, could have gotten the goal. It was only in the last 15 minutes where Inter then really was pressing forward, not being super dangerous, but also having their chances. And it took Ospina to go to make it. And then the funny thing is that Ospina had another twist and tail. I mean, yes, he got the assist. He gave up the goal. He saved Napoli. Then he gets a yellow card for time wasting, which means he's suspended for the final. A goalkeeper suspended for the final. That is stupid. That's stupidity right there. But hey, so Meret will probably be playing. So we have the final. Napoli hangs on. And we have a final Juve-Napoli, which I have to say is dicey because Sarri could win his first proper trophy in Italy, playing against a team that he got really known for. So I think that's quite an interesting affair. Quality-wise, Juve clearly is the better team. But I have to say, I don't think Napoli is without a chance. If they keep it, they looked fresh. Juve did not. So I'm looking forward to the final. Let's see how it will go. Anyway, let me know what you thought about those two games. If you watched any, give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like these. And I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, here are some videos and playlists that would be of interest to you too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, as it will keep you updated with all things that are rotating in my soccer universe. With that, I wish you a wonderful day. Bye.